Good evening, students. So today, as promised, we'll start with the osteology of the upper limb. And the first bone that we need to study in the osteology of the upper limb is the clavicle. So the bone in my hand now, what you can see is the clavicle. Now, whenever you talk about any bone, there are certain points on which you have to discuss a bone when it is asked for you in your exam. First thing is that you should hold the bone in the hand of the side which it is. Now, the clavicle in my hand is the left-sided clavicle, so I should hold this in my left hand. Now, this is my left hand, so I am holding this clavicle in the left hand. Now, so that is the first thing. I will discuss how to identify the side later. So, first thing, you have to identify the bone correctly. Second thing, you have to hold in that hand of which side that bones belong to. Meaning, if it is the left-sided clavicle, it will be held in the left hand. If it is the right-sided clavicle, it will be held in the right hand. The next point is to classify the bone. Now, clavicle is a long bone, okay? Now, by definition, long bone means a bone which has two expanded ends and a shaft in between. That and such a bone is called as a long bone, and clavicle is a long bone. But the peculiarity of the clavicle is that it is the only long bone which is placed horizontally in the body. You should know that clavicle is placed horizontally. So, it is the only long bone, please mark my words, it is the only long bone that is placed horizontally in the body. So that is the classification of the bone. Now you come to the osteology of the bone. As you know that every long bone has two ends and a shaft. So these are the two ends. This end is called as the medial end and this end is called as the lateral end. And in between these two ends, you have the shaft of the bone. Now because clavicle is placed horizontally, the two ends of the bone will be the medial end and the lateral end. And then you will have the shaft. Now how to identify the medial end? You can see that the medial end is quadrilateral, okay, and the lateral end, you can see this, it is flat. So this is how you have to identify medial end and lateral end. So medial end is quadrilateral and thick, and the lateral end is flat. And between these two ends, you have the shaft. The shaft of the clavicle, if you can see clearly, it is S shape, it is curved, okay. So first we'll concentrate upon the ends now. So what I told you, the medial end is quadrilateral and it is thick. Now this part of the clavicle is going to articulate with the sternum, meaning the manubrium sternum, to form sternoclavicular joint. And the lateral end, which is flat, you can see that there is a facet here. If you can observe here, if my finger is placed on the facet which is present on the lateral end of the clavicle. Now this facet is going to articulate with the acromion process of the scapula to form acromioclavicular joint. So the two ends of the clavicle, the medial end and the lateral end, identification I have told you, and what joints they are going to form, I hope you have understood. Now in between these two ends, there is a shaft which you can see. You can see, as I told you, the shaft is S-shaped, sinuously curved. And for descriptive purposes, the shaft is divided into two parts. This part is called as the medial two-thirds of the shaft, and then the smaller part is called as the lateral one-third of the shaft. Now, when you discuss the shaft, first the medial two-thirds and then the lateral one-third. Because the medial end is quadrilateral, the shaft of the medial two-thirds will have four surfaces. Anterior surface, which is facing the front. Then there is a posterior surface, which is facing back. There is a superior surface here and inferior surface. So the medial two-thirds of the shaft has four surfaces. Anterior surface, posterior surface, superior surface and inferior surface. Now how do you place this correctly? The anterior surface of the medial two-thirds is convex. You can feel it in your own body also. You can see that the anterior surface of the medial two-thirds is convex. So whenever you are going to hold it, you can see that this is the convexity which is present on the medial two-thirds of the shaft anteriorly. And the posterior one-third of the shaft, if you can observe, it is concave. The posterior one-third of the shaft is concave. So the anterior surface is convex, posterior one-third is concave. The superior surface of the shaft is smooth and subcutaneous. It does not have anything. Subcutaneous meaning lying beneath the skin. You can very easily see that superior surface. The inferior surface of the medial two-thirds is marked by a groove. This is the groove which is present on the inferior surface. This groove is the characteristic of the inferior surface, and this groove is called as subclavian groove. Okay, so that is how you have to identify the inferior surface. So this is very essential to know correctly how to place the clavicle, because if you place the ends or the surfaces wrongly, you can mistake the side. So if I am going to make the anterior surface concave or the posterior surface convex, then it is going to mistake the side. So I will repeat, the medial two-thirds of the shaft is quadrilateral, it has four surfaces, anterior surface, posterior surface, superior surface and inferior surface. Anterior surface of the medial two-thirds is convex, posterior surface of the medial two-thirds is concave, superior surface of the medial two-thirds is smooth and subcutaneous, and inferior surface has a groove which is present here, which is called as subclavian groove. So that is about medial two-thirds. Now we'll concentrate on the small part, which is the lateral one-third of the shaft. Now the lateral one-third, because the lateral end is flat, you can see that this end is flat. The lateral one-third of the clavicle has anterior border, which is thin, and a posterior border, and there will be a superior surface and an inferior surface. Okay, so there will be anterior border, posterior border, superior surface and inferior surface, as against the four surfaces which are present on the medial two-thirds. So how is the anterior border? The anterior border is concave. The posterior border is convex. This is exactly opposite to the medial two-thirds. The superior surface again here is subcutaneous and smooth, and inferior surface again here, if I can show you here, see, you can see an elevation here. This is called as conoid tubercle, and then there is a roughened area which is present here, which is called as a trapezoid ridge. So this has to be kept in mind, that the inferior surface will show this very clear cut tubercle here, and then there is a trapezoid ridge here. So this is called as conoid tubercle and trapezoid ridge. So whenever you take the clavicle in your hand, you should see for this first, and then place this surface inferiorly, and then accordingly place the anterior and the posterior surface, so that you don't mistake the side. So if you know what is medial, what is lateral, what is superior, what is inferior, what is medial and lateral, then you can clearly identify the side of the clavicle. So you know that this medial end is quadrilateral, lateral end is flat, anterior surface of the medial two-thirds is convex, anterior border of the lateral one-third is concave. So if we place this clavicle correctly, then you will see that this is the left-sided clavicle. And the most, I told you, the distinguishing feature of this is going to be the conoid tubercle and a trapezoid ridge, which has to be placed inferiorly. So the inferior surface has to be placed inferiorly only. Otherwise, if you place this opposite, all points remain correct. But if the inferior surface is placed superiorly, if this conoid tubercle comes superiorly, the side of the clavicle changes. That has to be kept in mind very, very clearly. Okay. So this is the osteology of the clavicle. I hope you have understood this. Now we'll talk about the muscle attachments. Now there are very few muscles which are attached to the clavicle. As I told you, if you talk about the anterior two-thirds of the medial two-thirds of the clavicle, the anterior surface gives origin to a muscle of the pectoral region. This muscle, the big muscle, is called pectoralis major. The posterior surface has no major muscle, but towards the medial end, you will have the origin of sternohyoid. The superior surface, again towards the medial end, is going to give origin to sternocleidomastoid. And inferior surface, as I told you, has a subclavian groove. And this subclavian groove is called subclavian groove because there is a muscle which is inserted here, which is called subclavius. And the subclavius is inserted here. And the margins of the groove will provide attachment to a very important fascia, which is called clavipectoral fascia. So I'll repeat, attachments on the medial two-thirds will be anterior surface of the medial two-thirds is going to give origin to pectoralis major. Posterior surface of the medial two-thirds towards the medial end is going to give origin to sternohyoid. Superior surface towards the medial end is going to give origin to sternocleidomastoid. Inferior surface in the subclavian groove is going to have the insertion of the subclavius. The margins of the groove is going to have the attachment of clavipectoral fascia. Is this clear? Now, talking about the lateral one-third. Lateral one-third, as we know, that it has anterior border, posterior border, superior surface and inferior surface. Two important muscles here. Anterior border is going to give origin to the deltoid, meaning the clavicular fibers of the deltoid. This muscle is deltoid. So anterior border is going to give origin to clavicular fibers of deltoid. Posterior border is going to provide insertion to trapezius. You have to be very specific whether a muscle is originating or inserted there. Superior surface, as we have understood, that it is subcutaneous and smooth. Nothing is attached here. Inferior surface, I told you, has the conoid tubercle and a trapezoid ridge, which provides attachment to a very important ligament which is present here, which is called as conoid and trapezoid parts of coracoclavicular ligament. Coracoid process is present in the scapula. So connecting the coracoid process and the scapula, this ligament which is present here inferiorly is called coracoclavicular ligament, and it has two parts, conoid part and trapezoid parts, which are attached to the conoid tubercle and the trapezoid ridge. I hope you have understood this. I missed out one thing which is present in the attachments of the medial two-thirds. If I can show you here, The inferior surface of the medial two-thirds has a facet here. If you can observe this facet, there is a small facet here, and this facet provides attachment to costoclavicular ligament. It is the connection between the first rib and the clavicle. I hope this is understood. So this is about the osteology and the important muscles that are attached to the clavicle. Now, because clavicle is a very interesting bone, it's the only long bone which is placed horizontally, there are few peculiarities of the clavicle which needs to be understood. The first peculiarity, as we all have discussed it, it is the only long bone which is placed horizontally. The second peculiarity is that it is subcutaneous throughout. You can see the clavicles easily through the skin. The third peculiarity is very important. It is the first bone to ossify in the body. The fourth peculiarity, it ossifies only in a membrane. Bones ossify from membrane and cartilage. So this clavicle ossifies only in a membrane, and because it ossifies in the membrane, it does not have a medullary cavity. So these are some peculiarities, and one last peculiarity which remains, it can occasionally be pierced by the supraclavicular nerve. So I'll repeat the peculiarities of the clavicle. First is, it is the only long bone which is placed horizontally. It is subcutaneous throughout. It has first bone to ossify in the body. It ossifies only in the membrane. It has no medullary cavity, and it is occasionally pierced by the suprascapular nerve. So these are peculiarities of the clavicle. Now, when you talk about any bone, the last part when you answer about the bone or what you should know, why you should study the bone, is to understand the applied anatomy. And the commonest thing which happens to the clavicle is fracture of the clavicle. And the fracture of the clavicle, which happens generally here at the junction of the medial two-thirds and the lateral one-third, because this is the weakest point of the bone. And this fractures when a person falls on the outstretched hand. When if a person is falling and he supports his hand like this, there can be a shear on the clavicle, and that can lead to fracture of the clavicle. Now, the treatment for the fracture of the clavicle is again very unique. There is a bandage which is attached to the fractured end, and then this bandage is taken anteriorly, it goes posteriorly in such a way that an 8 figure of 8 bandage, it is called. So the 8 figure is made on the back. So that is called as the treatment for fracture of the clavicle. This may be asked to you, and you should remember that the treatment for fracture of the clavicle is figure of 8 bandage. I hope you have understood the osteology, the muscle attachments, and the applied anatomy and the peculiarities of the clavicle. If there are any doubts, please write it in my comment section so that I can make the necessary improvements in my videos. Thank you. Please like, share, and subscribe my channel. And please make maximum use of these videos for your studies. Thank you once again.